Hello, this is Dr. Henchman, and welcome to Zedcraft. This is ZF's Patreon server, which I've been playing on recently, probably for about the last 6 weeks, and I thought I'd do an episode. I've been wanting to record a video for a while, just give it a go, and I thought I'd jump in the deep end. So, this is Spawn, this is World Spawn. We have ZF's face as our lovely landing pad. He's looking very handsome, a bit tan. This is World Spawn. The actual like town is quite a distance away, so we'll have to head through the Nether to get to that. But I figured I'd start here because if there's anyone else who joins the server, this is what they'll see to begin with. But I figured what we'd do is we'd do a small server tour, mainly of the things that I've been working on while I've been on the server. And then I'll kind of go into some details about what I'm working on next, and maybe we'll even be able to do a bit of work on that. So, as I said, this is the landing pad. I built this very recently, actually. Just to kind of give yourself, give the spawn, world spawn a little bit more love. Most people have kind of moved away from this area. So it's, yeah, it can be a little bit, confusing when you arrive. So created this, this little welcome message and, with some goodies for any new patrons joining. So, yeah, we'll head down this way. We've got an Iron Titan. I had no involvement in building that, but I have definitely been using the iron from it. We'll head into the Nether and get to town. All right, we finally made it. This is our Nether Hub. It was mostly built when I got here. We're kind of extending it either way and kind of adding tunnels off as we go. But I figured we'll kind of do the builds in pretty much in order of what I've done them. So we'll head to the residential district to start with, and I'll show off my my first build. So, pretty much when I got on the server, I noticed that, you know, most people had their houses set up, and I kind of wanted to plot out my area straight away. Scratching my head what to do, and I decided to build a Japanese-themed castle. Not massive castle, pretty humble, but yeah, this is it. It still needs the detail. I just kind of did the basic structure to begin with, and I've just put in this this kind of pond with the kind of little waterfall there and bridge over it recently. I'm not really sure what I feel about it, but we'll leave it there for now and see how we go. It's mostly just the exterior that's done. When we get inside, it's looking a bit bare. I have my storage chest over here, nether portal to the nether hub, and just a sneaky staircase down to my mining area down there. We have my to-do list over there. I won't go over and show you everything on it to start with, but I figured we'll head on to the next place, which is actually in the nether. And we made it. So what we have here is a double blaze farm. This is probably the only project I've really completed, well, not even completed, but This is one of the projects that I decided to do kind of between a number of projects, but I found these two blaze spawners right next to each other, and I thought it was too good to pass up. We have to make them into a farm. So this is using Nembon's design. It was also used by Impulse SV in Hermitcraft Season 4. And the way that it works is it doesn't use redstone to kind of push the blazes into the killing chamber. It uses just the raw game mechanics. So just to kind of briefly explain how it works is mobs in the game, they will wander. They kind of arbitrarily choose and kind of choose a point within a 16 within a 10 10 block radius of themselves, I believe, and it might be 16 block. They choose a random point and they try and wander towards it. But there's special conditions for which block it chooses, and pretty much they choose a solid block. So if that's the only solid block in the area, they'll see that and they're like, oh, I definitely want to get towards that. So what we do to exploit this is we remove all the solid blocks in the area. We only have transparent blocks like glass or slabs and stairs, and we put a whole lot of solid blocks in the middle. So what happens is I'll show you now is if we turn on this, which will get rid of the lava. So we have to stand up here for the range, and I will turn down the sounds. This farm can be a little bit noisy. Eventually, they'll start to wander towards. We're not in range of that one. They'll eventually start to wander towards the center spot. They'll fall down these gaps here. There's a little crusher system here. I believe this is Snow Crash's design. And then they get pushed out into this kind of L shape just here, holding area. So the good thing is that I've kind of tried to tweak this enough so that you can kind of stand anywhere along this path here and none of the blazes can see you. As long as they can't see you, they won't get angry. And the way the blazes kind of the AI works is if they get angry and then those guys up there get angry, they all kind of fly up and it kind of breaks the design. So you really have to have it so that they don't see you. And then you just hit them with a looting sword and get the drops down below. So I turn that off. And just to get rid of the excess blaze, you just move away from the area. So I've got a few blaze rods in here. Not a double chest yet, but I did a little bit of work. I figured if we get a double chest worth, that's probably enough. Probably not, but it's a good starting spot point. I guess people will use them for for end rods or for fuel. So we'll see what the server really wants them to do. So I figured on the way back I'll talk a little. Oh, hello, Pigman. I'll talk a little bit about the server. So there's probably about, I think there's about 10 active players on the server, not online right now. And if you haven't kind of figured out from my accent already, I am Australian. So I do play at odd times of the day compared to other people on the server. Most others are in the UK or in the US. So I see them on in, sometimes in the morning if I'm on or in the evening. But it's the middle of the day today, so there's no one else on at the moment. Yum 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 yum. So anything else? What else should I talk about? So the server's kind of, I'd say that it's a laid back server. Like, we like to do big builds, or like, we like to do builds and farms and whatnot. But we like to have fun as we're doing it. As I said, I've played on the server for about 6 weeks now. I've only probably done about three or four builds. I've been playing on the server, but just not kind of trying to make massive progress. Just kind of taking it at my own pace. And I think that's what most people are doing as well. While we're in the Nether Hub, the other thing that I did was... So originally, the Stronghold was way back, past the Iron Titan, back at World Spawn. But now that's, as of, I think it was 1.10 of Minecraft, they spawn more than three strongholds. There was one kind of a little bit closer, so I think it's about 100 blocks down that way is our portal to the end. I've worked on this tunnel here, but I'm waiting until Minecraft 1.12 comes out and the server is updated to kind of finish off that end of the port of the tunnel. I really want to make use of some of the concrete blocks. So where to head next to? I think the next thing that I want to do is head to the farming district. A little bit more about myself. I'm not really a big builder. I'm trying to... Oh, that's new. I'm trying to get better at building aesthetics, but I've been mostly kind of drawn to the game because of Redstone. I'm a developer, professionally, so I guess Redstone, kind of that technical aspect kind of interests me. This is probably the only build that I've finished in completion and actually kind of been semi-happy with, which is just, a too high flower duplicator. So it takes bone meal up the top here, and then it fills this double chest down here. And that's dispenser will... shoot out bone meal if there's bone meal up the top, or if the chest isn't full. If there's no bone meal or the chest is full, it'll turn off. And I've kind of gotten a couple of double chests of the different flowers, just so people can use them. I think some people are interested in using them for the dye, so we'll head over this way. We've got a couple of other builds by other people. Hopefully you'll be able to see some of those guys' names. You're probably the guys that are people that are watching this video are just from the server. But we'll head up this way. And this is the big project that I've been working on the server. So this is Honk Halls. So it is a villager trading, massive villager trading hall. It has four wings, and it has these are the holding cells where the villagers will go, and we can trade with them. So this design is one by a couple of smaller YouTuber, a tutorial was done by a smaller YouTuber called ACG, and I believe one of the other guys that he knows, Grifter Mage, I think it was the people that helped him come up with this design. Came up with this design, and ACG did the tutorial on it. So they both play on the Titancraft server, Tango's Patreon server. I used to play on that server. I decided to switch over to ZF's server. It's a little bit more my pace, a little bit slower, but we're still doing some cool stuff here. So the way that it kind of will work is we'll have a villager breeder either down below there or up a little bit in the sky, not too far. It'll still be in the encasing building. And when you... to request a villager, you'll come over, you'll hit a button, the position of this button may change. It will pick up the villager from the system, it will send them into one of these tracks, and they kind of come along here and they fall into the first slot that's available. Now, if all of the slots are available, they'll circle around, and then if all the slots are taken If all the slots are taken here, they'll circle around, and if all the slots are taken here, they'll come out here, and then they'll go to the next hall. You'll see that there's a track coming across the top here, and also a track coming from below. The way that I kind of want to do this is get it organized. So I kind of want to, you know, I have, actually I might come in the middle. You'll get a better view of the layout if I kind of pillar up a little bit here. So we kind of have these four quadrants, each with their own color floor to kind of help to organize. So the idea that I had is that we'll have, you know, the white coat villagers, like librarians, we'll have them down in this wing. In the brown wing, we'll have the brown coats, like the farmers. The other two wings, I figured we'll use them for the various other professions. Maybe we'll reserve one of them for kind of an area to sort, so we'll by default send the villagers to that one. And then we'll be able to kind of rotate them around. So I'll kind of explain that now. So the whole system kind of circles around both above, like if there's, you know, if it's trying to find a slot, but then also when you eject a villager, it will come, it will eject down and it will come up this ramp and around to the next one. So that's one of the modes of the system. The other one will be that you send, if you don't want to have the villager, it'll send it to its to villager island. It will, yeah, so you'll kind of toggle the system. We'll come back over to the sleeper here. So if you put it on cycle villagers, it will kind of cycle around, you know, ejected ones will come down and cycle up and around to the next and next part of the hall, the next quadrant. And if you put it on kill villagers in mode, they will fall down into a pit of lava. So it's not all wired up. You can see that I kind of started doing the wiring over there, but I still need to figure out exactly where I want those controls. They're, you know, up there right now, but I'm not too sure if that's exactly where I want them. I still don't know whether I want the breeder, you know, up in the sky or down below. We need to make sure that they're far enough away from, far enough away from the other villages so that they don't kind of interact with the breeder itself. And you can see that this is kind of the ejection system. So you get a villager coming down. They may go either way. So I just put a block at this end so that if they come this way, they'll just bounce off that one and go around the track that way. And then if we've got it in the cycling mode, they'll go that way. And then if we've got it in the kill mode, we'll send a redstone signal to this rail here. We'll switch it to this way. That will be powered. And let's see if I can do this without falling down. You'll see that there's a lava source down there where they can have, you know, a bit of a hot, you know, yeah, they'll die. yeah, this is very much a work in progress, and it's a kind of a long-term project. I don't want to burn myself out on this, so I've been kind of doing bits and pieces of this as I go. The design, the, you know, exterior design, not finalized. This entrance is not finalized. It will look something like this. I want it to kind of be open like that, and I'm using the kind of three carpet trick to get all of those back. Yep. I'm using the three carpet trick to trick the mobs, not so that they think that they can't get to the stairs. They kind of see that as a big drop. They don't see it as a valid place to walk, and they can't get in there. I actually just saw something that I forgot to mention, and it's way over there. Another one of my builds. I'm surprised I forgot about it. It's actually one of the other builds that I have kind of finished. Although I guess nothing is really ever finished, because I may be adding some stuff to it soon. So we'll hop over there. And that is a melon and pumpkin farm. So that is what this big melon is. and it has, you know, a couple of double chests for the melons and pumpkins. Ooh, it's got quite a lot in at the moment. Yeah, so people have been using it. We've got a kind of temporary villager trading area over there, so people can get their mending books. And I think people have been using it. It's a community farm, like people can use it, like that's the whole idea. So yeah, I guess it's good that it's not all full up. I probably need to do an AFK here at some point and just fill up the chests, just so that we've got plenty there. Yeah, so this is a melon pumpkin farm. I'll hop in the back here, because I think I used some interesting redstone mechanics to get it to work. This is Il Mango's design, so I'll just quickly pop up here. So this redstone here will trigger. It will push the trapdoors down, break the melons and pumpkins, and it'll pull it back up. And then the cart will go under and pick up all the melon and pumpkin. It's currently only a 9x9, so that's another reason why there's not so many. I'm planning to add maybe two more of this on top. It's kind of a stackable design. So maybe I'll put a pumpkin on top of this, and then I'll be able to fit two more above. It has to be a melon and pumpkin so that you can get the best spawn rates out of the growing area. It's got to do with... Oh, that's it going off then. The way that it works is, I think it's rows of melons and pumpkins, and because of that, if you have a pumpkin growing, then it doesn't interfere with the melons growing, so it doesn't have like the multiple stalks going into the same plant as it does in Minecraft. Probably a really bad explanation. The clock that I used is a sapling growth detector clock. So I kind of looked around for different clocks. I really want to try to not have too much of a lag footprint on the server. I say that after, you know, talking about this massive villager trading hall that I'm building, but we'll see how that goes. We'll see how many we can actually have in there comfortably. And one of the things I wanted to do was avoid hoppers too much. Make sure that they're covered if I need hoppers there. So I tried to avoid using a hopper clock. They're also susceptible to chunk unloading problems, so corruption and things, duplicating items and stuff like that. So I'll put on the debug, not that one, this one, I believe. Yes, so you can see that this whole thing, if I knock out that block and knock out that block, you can see that this whole thing is actually in a single chunk. I did that intentionally because I wanted it to be very friendly for unloading, chunk unloading on the server. So I wanted the whole mechanism to unload, all at once or load all at once. I didn't want it to kind of half unload and break. So I wanted to put the whole thing in a single chunk. Put the whole thing in a single chunk. And with the clock, I wanted to use something that didn't use hoppers. So I found this design. I can't remember who showed it off. It may have been Il Mango. I'll need to check that later. But what happens is this, we've got a 4x4 of spruce saplings here. They're trying to grow, But they can't because there's blocks right on top of them. But they still do a block state change, which the observer can then detect, and it sends out a pulse, and that will trigger the mechanism up above, where it pushes the trapdoors down and then pulls them back up. One of the things I do need to improve on this is trying to get rid of this this redstone dust. One of the biggest problems on with redstone, like redstone lag, is redstone dust. I may change this out for an observer chain at some point, just to kind of minimize the amount of dust that we have. But for now, I just kind of wanted to finish off the farm, get it functional, and we can always come back and fix up some of those things. So I think that's all I'm going to do for the server tour. I'll see how I'm going for time, and we'll come back later, and in a moment for you, and we'll maybe do some work on maybe on honk halls. All right, I checked the footage, and I've rambled on for far too long. So I'm going to cut the episode short here. If you enjoyed the episode, please let me know in the comments. If you have any feedback, please let me know. Let me know what you are interested out of the projects that I've been working on, what you'd like to see me work on in another episode if I feel like making one. That's all I have for you. This has been Dr. Henchman. I'll see you later.